Hello, South Africa. Sanbonani Emzansi. We're back again with another dynamic, beautiful, the gorgeous Cheryl Hlabane, who also happens to be my homegirl. So I'm going to talk Zulu because I'm here.
Exactly.
Cheryl, how are you?
I'm good, thanks, Aya. Good to see you again.
Good to see you again. Yes, true. Cheryl, for those at home viewers who don't know who you are, please tell us a little bit about yourself.
My name is Cheryl Hlabane, and I am the Center Operations Manager for Frieda Hartley Shelter. I'm a social activist. I'm a GBV activist. I'm an agent of change. And I'm someone who's really passionate about building human capital, especially where women and children are involved.
In a nutshell, tell us about what your organization does.
Our organization aims to empower women who are victims of GBV, victims of rape, women who find themselves homeless for a variety of reasons. There are a lot of women who are financially unemployed and they do not have anywhere to go, and therefore they are stuck with their abusers within the home because they depend on them financially.
That's a great point that you're raising about the economic financial independence. Stats have shown us and proven that a lot of women who go back to their abusers go back because they're financially dependent on them.
You know, we don't just give women a place to stay because we don't believe that that's their biggest problem coming through to us. So we definitely try and help the woman gain skills, find employment, and therefore become productive members of society.
Have you made strides? What programs do you have in place in terms of upskilling women? Are you working with governments? Are you involved in programs that are giving women skills to be able to support themselves? What are you practically doing?
We create our own skills. So we have such a great group of donors that come through and pay for skills development because it's also great for their CSI, you know, and they get points for their BEE. So we work with those organizations and they pay for the training for the woman or bring somebody to do the training in-house and technical training. And we have women that have gone through to colleges, to university, attained degrees, attained certificates, and some have received scholarships international.
That's lovely. Looking at your approach, what would you think or what would you say is your success rate?
Our success rate is 89%. I am so proud to say that because we work tirelessly, like to really try and make sure that when women come in, they come out absolutely, totally different. Like our success stories are so amazing. If people go through our website or our social media pages, they'll be able to see the woman that we help and the type of help that we have been able to provide for those women.
And you and I had a conversation earlier before we got to set, and we were talking about defining what GBV is. Which has become so complex in our days.
It's been boxed a lot. So GBV is usually considered as intimate partner violence only. And therefore, also when people talk about intimate partner, they're talking about your boyfriend, you know, whereas it could be your partner who is a female, or it could be two males, and it could be your mother, you know, physically and emotionally and financially abusing you. I don't think our own police service understand what GBV is as well. Because if you go as a woman and you're reporting, I mean, I've been in those instances where, you know, women come through and there's a huge fight and they go and report that to the police and they think it's just a joke. Especially in our own culture, you know, being black, they're like, first of all, why are you even dating a woman? They don't take that seriously. If you are married, it's also another thing. You know, you can't go and report that your husband beat you up. I mean, I'm sure, obviously,
if you live in
the suburbs, or your husband raped you. So if you live in the suburbs, chances are Sandton Police Station might take that a little bit seriously. But emadadeni, you can't go, you know, it depends on the areas, you know. So it really does boil back to culture, where if you go to emadadeni, you report that, who is even going to listen to you? It goes down in my DM. I always say that because we get messages differently from people. And there's a young lady who called me needing help. In Deep Slut, and she called the police station and they told her there were no vans. And I told her, tell the police, Uguti, there's somebody that's selling alcohol next door illegally. And the police were there within 30 minutes, but there were no vans for her. So this is the fight that we are fighting all the time. You have to, your pizza delivery will arrive before the police.
Do you think it's getting better? Do you think it's getting worse? Are we curbing? Are we making strides in trying to curb it?
We try. We try. However, I don't think our efforts match. So it continues to be a big problem because they don't take us seriously from PeZulu. So if your own government does not take it seriously and they only talk about it only when we march, we had to start the total shutdown and shut down the entire country and go and march to the union buildings and give the president 24 demands. And yes, he had the first ever GBV summit and we were all there and we listened to the president talk to us and tell us that he's going to declare GBV as a national state of emergency. After that, Luto, our government has such great policies. They're very good on pinning things down. But in terms of action, nothing is happening.
That thing keeps coming the government, up over and over
exactly,
again.
Exactly. We have so many organizations that have shut down because they're not getting funding. Where is the money for that? You understand? So it's literally just getting worse and worse all the time because we're not getting the support from where we should get it. We do get corporate support, but it's not enough because NABO, they have a limited budget and not everybody can support GBV. Other people are supporting pregnant women, other people are supporting orphans, other people are supporting the elderly. So only a small portion goes into GBV. And because people also don't even understand GBV, they're very skeptical in terms of donating because they're thinking, hey, these women are lazy, why don't they just go and look for work?
What is your organization's vision for the future of South Africa? What kind of South Africa would you like to see?
We would definitely love to have a GBV-free South Africa. A space where women can walk in the street. Like when I'm saying just walk to the street without fearing anything. I carry a taser, a pepper spray, if I had a smaller knife, I would also carry that. A pocket knife, I would also carry that. So just those kind of small things where people might think they're petty, but those are the things that have really psychologically damaged women in our country.
What can men in South Africa do to take a firmer stance against GBV?
I think let's go back to the beginning. Let's go to schools. When we teaching young girls about menstruation, and other things that happen to young women, those are the conversations that we should have with men as well. We always exclude men. We need to change the narrative from ekuqaleni.
Talk to South Africans. Tell them, what can people do to help your organization?
I mean, obviously, financially, our organization runs with funds. You know, there's utilities, there's water and lights, there's a whole lot of things. We're always looking for funds in order for us to keep our doors open. But that's not the only way. There are donations in kind, there are donations in groceries, there are donations in skills development, like we've spoken. We do one of the most important things for us is to empower women through skills development. However, they can go through to our website, which is www.fridahartley.org. Alternatively, give us a call on 011-648-6005, where they can get full information and on, you know, in terms of how they can assist us. We are a registered nonprofit organization with tax certificates. So corporates that do want to donate, they will be able to get a Section 18A certificate to help their business.
Oh, Cheryl, thank you so much.
Thanks, Sissy.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
For joining me and for having this heartfelt conversation. May you continue to walk on this journey of greatness.
Thanks.
As we prepare for a better and progressive South Africa. May your name be among those who will be counted as one of those who really made an impact in our society.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
I want to say Mbobodo, but I don't like that word Mbobodo because
it's like
we don't break.
Yeah,
Mbobodo,
exactly.
Like this is a stone.
No, siyaphuka.
But power to you.
Thank you. Thanks, Aya.